Today's video is on the Jardini Arowana.
Let's jump right into a live feeding. Here is a crayfish. Look at that striking power. It's absolutely insane. The Jardini is a super, super aggressive arowana. And let's slow-mo this. Let's go back a little bit. Look at that striking power. This is why I love arowanas, guys. It's just crazy.
The Jardini doesn't grow as large as the silver arowana, but it has more of an attitude. It has more punch. It's going to be more aggressive. People complain about being able to keep tank mates with it, and it has different finnage design, and it has a different coloration. It's just a pure beauty in itself, and the Jardini is a very popular arowana. One of my personal favorites.
Did you know it's actually pretty common for a Jardini arowana to be passed off as an Asian arowana? People have bought them and they go back to the fish store and they're like, hey man, my arowana grew out and it turns out to be a Jardini, except I paid 5 times the amount of money thinking it was an Asian arowana. Like, what the heck? It's because they look very similar as juveniles, and that's what makes the Jardini arrow so popular, is because it is somewhat similar to the Asian and it's a lot cheaper in price. I want to give full credit to Justin Ambrosi for this video. I was looking for quite some time of a good looking healthy Jardini arrow, and he has this stellar of a male. Make sure to follow his Instagram. It's up in the right hand corner, East Coast Herpetology. I asked Justin, I said, hey man, what are the main battles when it comes to owning a Jardini? Because I know a lot of us keep these big fish and we kind of just take for granted we're all going to stuff it in a glass box and things are going to be okay, and we're going to feed them just carnivorous predator food with lots of protein. But he gave me some good tips. He found out that over time, even though the Jardini is super, super aggressive, it also gets pretty timid. Like, if he moves around decorations in the tank, the thing won't eat for a couple of weeks. And his biggest obstacle is finding tank mates. A lot of people buy arowanas and they're hoping that they're gonna have other cool tank mates. But in Justin's case here, he hasn't found a fish that this thing has got along with. You wake up with a dead fish, so be aware. If you're thinking of getting a Jardini, these things are crazy aggressive. Like I said, Justin, he said this thing will go weeks without eating, which is just absolutely crazy to me. A lot of us start to worry when their fish doesn't eat after a couple of days, but fish can literally go weeks in their natural habitat, and it's a good thing to know. He also said that the biggest thing you got to be aware of is tank lids, because arowanas like to jump. We all know this. A lot of people think that, you know, having a little spot open for like a filter, literally you need to be crazy as far as having tank openings, because these things will slither through the opening and you'll wake up with your beautiful fish laying dead on the ground. Jardini arowanas will commonly grow around 2 feet long, and that's kind of where they max out. And that's why a lot of people like the Jardini, because they don't get as big as the silver arowanas. And you can just tell by the cosmetic appearance of this thing, they do have some different finnage as far as, you know, it has that bottom fin kind of like the black arowana. Me and Justin were kind of going back and forth talking about like what a good tank size is for arowanas, because it's an elongated fish and, you know, they grow as long as a lot of people's tank width, and that's kind of the big thing to watch. A lower, shallower, wider tank is a better tank for arowanas because they're mainly just using the top surface, and these things grow 2 feet long, so he thought that a 6 foot by 2 foot by 2 foot tank would be an absolute bare minimum, because when they're turning around in the tank, that 2 foot span is actually the width of the tank. And if you want my honest opinion, they're probably better suited in a bigger tank than that. But I mean, we're being honest, we're keeping monster fish in small little habitats. It's just the bitter truth of it. But make sure you have enough filtration. Get yourself some crazy canister filters, some FX6s, just anything you can get your hands on. Build a custom sump, do crazy water changes. It is said that arowanas sometimes get hooked on live feeders. That is a whole other topic in itself, but try to get them some pellets in their system to make sure that they're getting some vitamins. This is just basic fish care for arowanas in itself, but the Jardini, is very close to my heart. I hope to someday own one. It kind of sucks because you might wind up with a single species tank, but even if so, they are extraordinarily beautiful, very similar to the Asian arowana. So if you can't get your hands on an Asian arowana or it's illegal like here in the US, maybe the Jardini arowana is a good fish for you. I've actually never even seen one at a fish store, so I would have to personally special order one, but that might be your case too. Hit up the comments, let me know what you think of the Jardini, if you've had any struggles keeping these fish or other arowanas. All right, guys, whoop!